Longtime friend and colleague Ron Smith was remembered today in a public memorial service.
Yeah, the longtime talk show host on WBAL radio died before Christmas after a very short battle with pancreatic cancer.
Yeah. We got our story on today's service from another one of Ron's many colleagues, Jane Miller.
Jerry Sandusky, and it is my great pleasure to be your host today as we celebrate the life of Ron Smith.
It was a service that remembered both the public Ron Smith and the private one. Stan Stovall was Ron's close friend for 34 years.
You know, everybody asked me this morning, how are you going to handle today? And I said, I'm fine. Fine. And I'm not.
Financial analyst Jonathan Murray spoke of being intimidated by Ron when he first worked on Ron's show, but came to know a much different man as the years went by.
I discovered that Ron was really just a big, really smart Oreo cookie. He was hard and crunchy on the outside and warm and soft on the inside, and that inside was absolutely filled with love.
From Channel 11, Maryland's leading news station, this is Action News.
The service included a video of Ron's career that started as the golden-haired anchor on Action News and evolved into the self-proclaimed voice of reason on the radio.
Listen up, liberals, conservatives, moderates, whatever you may be. I guarantee you that we will say things to upset you within the next 3 hours.
Ron Smith was insightful, intelligent, engaging, articulate, loquacious. But we're not here to canonize Ron, because Ron was also enraging, maddening, outrageous, outlandish, opinionated.
The audience today included Senators Mikulski and Cardin, both Democrats, and former Governor Bob Ehrlich, a Republican. Ron's listeners came too.
I'm a longtime listener of Ron's show, and I just loved him, and I just feel like I'm grieving a person that I never met.
He's probably the most influential person in my life, and particularly in people cooperating and getting along despite any differences of opinions.
In a nod to what's coming up Sunday, Jerry Sandusky held up the game ball the Ravens gave Ron shortly before he died. And Ron's boss shared the last words he heard Ron speak.
I hugged him, and I kissed him on the cheek, and he said to me, he whispered in my ear, "Go Ravens."
Continuing on is the effort to raise money in Ron's memory for pancreatic cancer research. Under the banner Team Reason, $28,000 has been raised to date. I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.
And it was a marvelous tribute. You can watch each of them online in their entirety. It's on WBALTV.com. Click on local news, where you can also find a link to donate to Team Reason. And you, along with so many others, just did a marvelous job.
It was a wonderful service.
It really was.
You know, one of the mementos that I will forever cherish is this picture. I went deep into the files. 1978, see? Ron and I anchoring here at BAL. Big afro, big mustache,
love the
right?
Dudes.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Ron, I love you. We all miss you.
He would love that.
And that's something.
Yeah.
And that's something. All
yeah, right. You want to check it out online because it's really.
Yeah, we'll post it there.
I felt like I had been given a gift today after
you
I left
and me
there.
Both.
It was
you and me
amazing.
Already. Well, still.